Okay, number five now, we're asked to find all real numbers t which satisfy this equation. Now remember, we identify real numbers with radians by wrapping the real number line around the unit circle. So essentially, we can just think of solving this equation for angles in radian measure theta, and then that corresponds exactly to the real numbers we want t. All right, so what angles have a cosine of 0? Well, if we plot the angles in standard position, in order to have a cosine of 0, that means that the x-coordinate of the point on the terminal side of theta, which lies on the unit circle, is 0. And if the x-coordinate is 0, that can either happen on the positive y-axis or the negative y-axis. So what are our two cases here? So it's a quadrantal angle, so t could be pi over 2, or it could be it could correspond to any angle coterminal with pi over 2, which would be 2 pi k, where k is 0, plus or minus 1, plus or minus 2, etc. Or it could be t could correspond to the angle 3 pi over 2. That would get us on the negative y-axis. Plus any integer multiple of 2 pi. All right, now this isn't incorrect, but we can actually shorten things up a little bit. Why? Because these two things, the terminal sides of these two angles are actually exactly pi units apart. We can actually combine these solutions to be any angle whose terminal side is pi units away from pi over 2. Or I could put a 3 pi over 2 there. Okay. So in order to actually check this out, when in doubt, write it out. Start listing out the values of t we get from this family. List out the values of t we get from this family, and you'll see that we get the exact same values we get from this family. So that'll do it for number five. Okay, number six, we're given some information about one of the great pyramids of Giza, and we're asked to determine how tall it is, the height of the pyramid. So let's sketch out the problem situation. Here's my best impression of a pyramid. Now, one of the pieces of information we're given is the slant height. The slant height of the pyramid is the height of one of the triangular faces. So here's one of the faces of the pyramid. And if I look at the height of that triangle, so if I look at the distance from the top of the triangle down to the base, and I look at that height there, it's 578 feet. So this is measuring a distance along the side of the pyramid. What we're also given is an angle of inclination. So if I look at a cross-section of this pyramid, then the angle of inclination here is 52 degrees. Now ultimately, I'm after how tall the pyramid is, which would be this height, the height of the cross-section, h. Where does the slant height come into play? Well, that's the distance along the face of the pyramid. So that's going to be right here. So what I have in here is a little right triangle. Well, little by comparison, I should say. Well, this is the side I'm trying to find, that's the side I know, and that's an angle I know. So which trig function can I use to relate these pieces of information? Well, I have an angle, I'm looking for the length of the side opposite that angle, and I have the length of the hypotenuse. So I can use the sine function. So the sine of 52 degrees is equal to the length of the opposite side h over the length of the hypotenuse, 578. That means that h is equal to 578 times the sine of 52 degrees. Now, if you plug this in your calculator and make sure you're in degree mode, you'll find this is approximately 455 feet. So, that'll do it for number 6, and that'll do it for Checkpoint Quiz 10.2.